In cell C7, I would like to write a formula that will determine the letter grade of each student based on the associated percentage grade. If you notice in cells B1 through B5, I have a percentage, and in cells C1 through C5, I have the letter grade. Anything under 60% would be an E. Anything under 70% would be a D. Anything under 80% would be a C. Anything under 90% would be a B. And 90% and above would be an A. I could use an if function, but the if function would be very complicated and prone to errors. In addition, I'm only checking for the letter grade of A, B, C, D, or E. What if I want to check for a minus or a plus? We would need to use many more embedded ifs, which would make the function prone to many more errors. Instead of using the if function, it would be more appropriate to use the VLOOKUP or HLOOKUP function. The VLOOKUP function finds an entry from a vertical list based on a criteria or a lookup value. The HLOOKUP function finds an entry from a horizontal list based on a criteria or a lookup value. In this case, we will use the VLOOKUP function because our list is a vertical list. In cell C7, we will type in VLOOKUP. The syntax, the first argument is the lookup value. The lookup value is in cell B7. That is the percentage that we're trying to find. The table array argument is the list. The list begins at B1 and it ends at C5. The leftmost column of the list should contain the table range. The rightmost column should contain the value. Notice the list does not include the headings. The column index num argument is the column number in your range that contains the corresponding data. The range lookup argument can either be true or false. True finds the exact match or the next lower value in your table array or your list. False finds an exact match in your list. Because we are looking for an exact match or the next lower value in the list, we will use the true argument. The true argument is the default value. The function returns the letter E. Because I want to copy this down, I always want the range to stay the same, so I put dollar signs in front of the numbers. Let's dissect this function. The lookup value argument is 55% in this case. The range is B1 to C5, which is my table or my list. The 2 is the column index number, and my range lookup is true, meaning I need to find a value without going over. Because I have a 2 as the column index number, once I find that value without going over, it will return the entry in the second column of the list. My list starts in B, so it returns the second column, 1, 2. In cell B7, I have the value 55%. The closest value without going over is 0% in B1. The function will return the value E. In cell C8, I have the value 60%. The closest value without going over is in cell B2, which is the 60%. It will return the letter D. If I have a value that is 90% or greater, an A will display in the cell. Let's go ahead and copy this down. And there are my answers. There are two rules to follow when using the range lookup argument of true. Number one, the leftmost column must be in ascending order. Number two, the beginning value in the list must be the lowest possible lookup value. The false range lookup argument must find an exact match in the array or table. If it does not find an exact match, then the error pound NA will display. When using the false argument, it's a good idea to include an if error function. Here, if I receive a pound NA, I'm just going to display the message that the grade was not found. The hlookup function finds an entry from a horizontal table based on a lookup value or a criteria. Syntax is the same as the vlookup. Looking up the 55%. Now my range starts E2 and goes to I3. If I find the answer, I want to return the second row. So I have a 2 here, and I'm looking for the closest value without going over. I'm copying this down, so I need dollar signs in front of the number. And there are my answers.